one way that you can spend time with God, by reading the Bible and praying.
This is another way you can honor God, by giving Him treasure and money.
To honor God, this was my talent in singing. La 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 la, God is our Lord.
So I take this time to stop up.
So we honor God with our testimony.
We honor God with our testimony. God keep on waking me up.
Thank you, Lord Jesus, for this day, and I hope coronavirus stops, and I hope people get start killed. I hope that people get treated well. I hope that lives get saved, and I hope that God will bring hope and help the people that are in pain by the coronavirus. Amen.
What up, Kid Nation? This is Mr. Chris coming to you today with the word from God. So we was going over the story of Balaam and his donkey and how their story unfold and, you know, what happened with him and the King Balak of Moab. I know that's a whole lot of names that we're not quite used to, but just bear with me, okay? So in the story with Balaam and his donkey, the interesting thing is that we don't really know what Balaam's connection to the Lord is. You know, we don't know if he was actually a follower of God or he was into witchcraft. We don't know any of that stuff. And the interesting thing is the Lord was able to use him regardless of the circumstances. The king Balak wanted to use Balaam to curse Israel. And Balaam told him to say, hey, I'll talk to God to see what he wants to do. And God told him not to do it. And then even when Balaam went all the way to Moab, to the kingdom of Moab, to see Israel so that he will follow the king's instructions, he had the king set out the sacrifices. He went to the high places to do worship. He talked to God, and God told him, nope, we're going to bless him. And we did this three times. Three times, and God blessed Israel. He used Balaam to bless Israel. Now again, Balaam wasn't a part of the Israelites. He was from a different country or a different nation. And again, we don't really know his relationship with God, but the interesting part is that God protected Israel regardless of what the king Balaam wanted to do. The king was scared, and he wanted to use a person that is renowned for casting blessings and curses on people. And God even used a person who had nothing to do with Israel to bless Israel. And that's how God will protect you. Even when people come against you, even when people come against your household or your church or whatever the case may be, God can use even your enemies to bless you. And not only once, but three times. And that's an amazing thing. And even on the journey with Balaam going to the kingdom of Moab on his donkey, God spoke to him even then when he ran into the angel. And, you know, the angel told him, say, hey, you know, you got to go. The interesting thing about Balaam is that in the beginning, when the king sent his messengers to recruit him to his side, he even told them then, let me talk to God, see what he wants to do. Now, again, we don't know what Balaam's relationship with God is, but he knew who God was. And though he wasn't part of Israel, he wasn't scared to talk to God. And so he went to talk to God, and God told him not to curse Israel, but to bless him. Actually, no, he didn't even tell him to bless him at the time. He just said that Israel was blessed and not to curse him and not to go with the messengers of Moab. And then, of course, they came back again, and, you know, he told them the same thing. He said, hey, the king can offer me anything that he wants to offer me. He can offer me his whole kingdom, his castle, his treasures, all that. But if God don't say it, I can't do it. And he stuck to that. And though he went with them on his journey, of course, he ran into the angel and everything. And God spoke to him twice then. God spoke to him through his donkey. I mean, isn't that crazy? Have you ever heard a donkey talk? Would you be scared? I'd be scared if I hear a donkey talking to me, because donkeys aren't supposed to speak words. It's kind of cool, but it's kind of scary at the same time. And then, of course, Balaam had a chance to speak with the angel, who was representing God at the time, talking about, you know, what he wanted Balaam to do, and told him that, you know, he could have taken him out right then. You could have died right then. But I decided to let you go to the kingdom of Moab. I mean, then but when you get there, though, wait for me to talk to you about what to do. And, you know, that's crazy. You know, again, when potential enemies are coming against you, to curse you, coming from wherever they're coming from, you know, God can intervene. God can take over. God can instruct them to not go against you. God can change the hearts of your enemies so that they can't curse you, but they can bless you instead. Not to say Balaam was initially an enemy, but he was being used by the king to be an enemy. He was being used by the king to be a weapon against Israel. And as a believer, we just got to understand that even when people are plotting against us, trying to use supernatural powers or whatever the case may be, God is in control. God can talk to them. God can change their heart. God can change their mind, just like he changed ours, and help us to believe in him. And then even when somebody tries to use you against somebody else, you know, like Balaam, it was like, no, I can't just go with what you say. I got to talk to God, because what you're saying don't sound right, and I know who God is, so let me talk to God to see what he wants me to do, because I'm not just going to go out here and trying to hurt somebody because, you know, because my sister says so, or because my brother says so, or my cousin, even teachers, and sometimes even parents, you know, if they're telling you to do things that are against God, you got to see God sometimes, and, you know, and let God handle that, even address the parents. Not to say that would happen often, but, you know, you never know. Sometimes my kids correct me, so I'm not saying go out there and do that, but, you know, keep your connection with God, keep praying with God, and he'll continue to protect you. And in the end, even use your enemies to bless you, not only once, but three times, and give you great blessings, and bless not only yourself, but your family and the people that are connected to you. You know, Israel isn't just one person. Israel is a whole nation, you know, and God used Balaam to bless a whole nation, three times, on three different mountains, on three different locations. It was crazy. But be blessed. I hope you learned something from this.
The Israelites came to the edge of the Promised Land. They camped near the Jordan River in the plains of Moab. By now, all of the previous generation had died except for Moses, Joshua, and Caleb. Balak, the king of Moab, saw the Israelites and was afraid. If the Israelites moved into Moab, they could take over.
King Balak sent his messengers to a man named Balaam. The king said, "Come and curse the Israelites so that I might be able to defeat them." The king believed that whomever Balaam cursed became cursed, and whomever he blessed became blessed. When Balaam went with the king's officials, God sent an angel to stop Balaam. Balaam could not see the angel, but his donkey could.
Three times the angel stood in the way, and three times the donkey stopped. First, the donkey went off the road. Then she ran into a wall. Finally, she crouched down on the ground. Balaam didn't understand why the donkey was stopping. He hit the donkey with his stick, so God gave the donkey the ability to speak. "What have I done to you that made you beat me three times?" the donkey said. "You made me look like a fool," Balaam said.
God then allowed Balaam to see the angel, and Balaam said, "I was wrong. I didn't know you were trying to stop me. If you don't think I should go, I'll return home right now." The angel said, "It's all right for you to go, but you must only say what I tell you." When he arrived, Balaam told the king, "I will only say what God tells me to say."
Balaam told the king, that God had blessed the Israelites. So Balaam blessed them too. In fact, he blessed them three times. The king was angry. "I brought you here to curse the Israelites, but you have blessed them," he said. "Go home." Before Balaam went home, he had a special message for the king. Balaam said that one day the Lord would be born to the people of Israel. The message was a special promise. "I see him, but not now. I perceive him, but not near. A star will come from Jacob, and a scepter will arise from Israel." After Balaam had said these things, he went home.
Balaam could not curse God's people. God had blessed the Israelites, so Balaam blessed them too. 1,400 years after Balaam announced God's promise, Jesus was born. God sent Jesus to bless the whole world by rescuing people from sin.
So I want you to think about a time when somebody wanted to use you to go against somebody else. When somebody wanted you to hurt somebody on their behalf, or wanted you to gang up against somebody because they were mean to them, or wanting to talk bad about them or spread rumors. You got to remember that you want to give yourself to God and let God instruct your steps so that you don't do anything evil and do anything corrupt, because God doesn't really want us to be cursing people, but he does want us to bless people. Though we have the power to curse, God wants us to bless. That is the focus. And wants to bless people, not to do evil, not to represent ourselves or represent the people who's asking us, but God wants us to represent him and wants us to represent his love. And we can't do that if we're just agreeing with our friends or our relatives who wants us to do things that may not be good, or even, you know, yourself, if you feel like you want to say something bad to somebody else. You know, give your cares to God, give your problems to God, and let him sort it out for you, okay? Let him bring the healing in your heart, let him bring the forgiveness in your heart, so that you can walk in love and you can walk in peace, all right? So you're not offending anybody and then you're not cursing anybody, because to curse somebody sucks, to be cursed, and you don't want that problem, and you don't want to be the source of that problem for somebody else. So be great and be with love. I love you guys. Can't wait to see you guys again. Have a good day.